help everybody with their PNM bill here today. We're going to give you some money-saving energy tips and chat with Shannon Jackson, who is our guest here on Coffee and Conversation. She's a spokesperson for PNM. And Shannon, it's good to see you again. Thank you for coming down to be with us here.
Good morning, Larry. Thank you.
Nice to have you here. Yeah. We're going to talk about the energy saving in the coming hot weather.
Yep.
Not here yet, but
it's coming quickly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. One day we're going to wake up and it's going to be 98 degrees and spring will be over, right?
Yeah, I mean, not by the looks of it outside, but
not
it's going
today,
to be here before we know it.
Yeah, it's coming. So, summertime, I'm guessing, is a high energy time for PNM. The energy, on hot days, energy use really goes up, doesn't it?
It does, and I think that mainly comes from people who are just wanting to stay cool in their homes. You know, the hotter it gets outside, we feel it in our bodies, we feel it in our families. You know, and we're just trying to stay cool and comfortable, but along with that comes higher energy usage or higher energy bills. But there are some things you can do around your home to help lessen that.
This is a good time to work on those. So let's run down some ideas here.
Sure. So some practical ways that can help your listeners and your viewers save some energy and some money are some things that we might not even think about. You know, whenever we wake up in the morning, I'm one of those people that likes my home to be bright. You know,
yeah.
And start the morning off well, which I think is okay,
yeah, sure.
But it's easy to scurry out of the home and forget to close those blinds. Because even if you have your temperature, your thermostat set appropriately, if you leave your home with all of your windows and your blinds open, then you're heating your home even though nobody is there, and then your cooler has to compensate, right? So it has to cool down your home. And so paying to have your air conditioner or your cooler working when nobody's there doesn't make too much sense.
Yeah.
So make sure to close those blinds and curtains whenever nobody's there. The other thing some people can do too, which I think it's easy to overlook, is all of the ceiling fans in your home in the spring and summertime, make sure to have them turning counterclockwise. That pushes cool air down and it makes it feel cooler and colder in your home.
Right. Ceiling fans are amazing.
Yeah.
I put some new ones in the house. It made a huge difference.
It does.
Yeah.
And if you don't look at it closely, you might not even realize that if you get right up under it and you look at like kind of where the blades are, there's a little switch that lets you toggle back and forth.
Right.
Make sure that it's going counterclockwise in the summer.
Yeah. Blowing down. Get that heat down. But these are interesting tips and stuff people just don't think of. But over time, they'll save you a lot of money.
They are. And one thing, too, that I wanted to bring up is something called phantom energy. So people often think that if I'm not using an appliance or an electronic of some kind, if I'm not actually using it, it's not drawing electricity. But there's this thing called phantom energy or standby energy. So maybe we do it, maybe we're guilty of it, but cell phone chargers are a great example, right? So we have it charging. Sometimes we charge overnight, our cell phones overnight. We unplug it in the morning and we go off on our day, but it's still plugged into the wall.
Yeah.
Even if your cell phone is not plugged into it, it's still drawing electricity and you're still paying for that electricity. And so you can do things like unplug it when you're not using it. It wouldn't really be practical for me to suggest that you should unplug your TV or, you know, your computer when you're not there, but there are some things that are a little bit easier to do. For example, your toaster or a blender, anything that you have in your kitchen that's just sitting on your countertop, you can unplug that and plug that back in when you're using it pretty easily. Same thing perhaps for a coffee pot, unless it's on a timer.
Right.
Then you might not want to do that. But there are some little things that you can do to save from spending that money on that phantom energy.
So if it's plugged in, it's drawing juice.
Absolutely it is.
Yeah.
And the reason why that happens is because whenever you need that appliance or electronic to work, you've got to have that electricity like that, right? It needs to start producing electricity and power for you right away. So it always has that standby energy. And a good indicator of that is if at night, if you turn off all of your lights, you have little lights staring back at you, you know that that's drawing electricity.
Very interesting. Can I ask you about what happens inside of PNM? Let's say it's a hot day. You guys know it's going to be a big energy use day. Is there a big control room somewhere that people are watching the power levels and things to monitor all this?
There are. It's something that we have to plan for, right?
Yeah.
So as New Mexico's largest energy company, we have to plan for the electricity usage that's going on with all of our customers. PNM has 525,000 customers all across New Mexico. And so we have to plan for that. So when we look at the weather ahead, whenever we see that it's going to be triple digits, we have to plan for that. So we do have something called a Power Saver Program. It's a voluntary program for residents and business customers that if you have refrigerated air, which uses a significantly amount more of electricity than swamp coolers or evaporative coolers, you know, we have to make sure that everyone has the electricity that they need, right, that when they flip on that light switch, that power comes on.
Yeah. We're visiting with Shannon Jackson with PNM, some energy saving tips while we head to the warmer months and while you're on vacation. Let's talk about a home energy checkup. This is something PNM has been offering for a long time.
It is.
Tell us what that is and how you get one.
Sure. So a home energy checkup is something where PNM sends out an energy advisor to your home and kind of sees room by room how each customer is using the electricity. You know, an energy ambassador will show up and will say, I'm going to look through all of your rooms. I'm going to look at your lighting, your heating, your cooling, all of these things, and see if you're wasting energy or if you're using it wisely. And if you don't mind, Larry, I'd love to say a little story about my personal experience with it. I feel like I can't really talk about our programs unless I have them done personally, right? Sure. And so I scheduled one, and don't judge me by saying this, but when I say this, but I didn't tell the person that I work for PNM when I scheduled it, and because I wanted an authentic
experience,
right?
I think that was good idea.
And so I kind of knew what the ambassador was going to say before he even said it, right? Because I'm so familiar with the program. So he came over to my home and he said, I'm going to look at your lighting, your appliances, your heating, your cooling, your insulation. I don't care if you have a junk drawer or junk closet. Everyone has that. That's not what I'm here for. So he was looking at all of my light bulbs in this instance, and I have some recessed lighting in my living room, and he went to go unscrew one of the light bulbs, and it burned his hand. And he said, okay, I'll be right back out. I need to run out to my truck and get a heat glove. I said, okay. So he came back in, and he took the light bulb out, and he held it out in front of me, and he said, do you know what this is?
It's a light bulb.
And I wasn't trying to be coy or smart aleck, but I mean, yeah, it was a light bulb, right? I didn't really know what he was getting at. And he said, yes, it is a light bulb, but it is not meant to light your living room. It's actually meant to be in a restaurant to heat food. And you have that in your home.
Wow.
And he said it was several hundred degrees, that light bulb. And it was way too hot. And honestly, it was a fire danger in my home.
I would say.
And so he took that out and he replaced it with an energy efficient light bulb, an LED light bulb. And then he did some other things, checked some other things all around my home. But the very next month, my PNM bill dropped $15. And I truly believe it's because I had a heat lamp. And he said, didn't you feel how hot it was getting in your home? Like, under that light? And I said, you know, as embarrassing as that is working for PNM, I did. I did notice it, but I would either dim the lights or I would just sit somewhere else. Because frankly, who thinks about lighting until their light bulb actually burns out? Probably most people.
Nobody, yeah.
Right. So, I mean, from that perspective, just having that home energy checkup was valuable to me. Because he found something that saved me energy and money and perhaps maybe even saved my house from catching on fire.
Well, you've got a hot bulb up there, a couple of hundred degrees after a while. Wow.
Right. But heating and cooling can sometimes attribute up to about 50% of our bills. And so as these triple digit temperatures start, you know, approaching quickly here in New Mexico, it's something that you want to think about. Because every degree higher that you can set your thermostat, it's going to save you money on your bill.
How do you get a home energy checkup? What do you do?
So you can just call PNM at 888-DIAL-PNM, or you can go online to PNM.com. It's right there on the homepage. You can see where it says how to save energy and money, and you can sign up for one. Typically, we're a couple of weeks out, but it's something that's certainly valuable and making sure that you're using energy in a way that's going to save you the most amount of money.
And it's a free service. Why not?
Well, for low income, it's free. For low income customers, it's free. Otherwise, it's about $15 for most customers.
Well, still very valuable.
For sure.
Couple more quick things. The Good Neighbor Fund, you see that on your utility bill.
Yeah.
What does that do?
So the Good Neighbor Fund is something where you can choose to round up or donate more money towards families who need it. So if you know somebody, I think we all kind of do probably, if we're not struggling ourselves, we know somebody who might be in a position to where they have to think, you know, do I pay for my bills? Do I pay for medicine? Do I pay for a mortgage? And having to face those difficult questions is not something that we want people to face. And so while we do provide reliable, affordable energy to New Mexico customers, we do also realize that sometimes people just need a hand up. And so if you are able to donate even the spare change or, you know, a few more bucks, then what that does is that goes towards the Good Neighbor Fund. And then if there are any low-income New Mexico customers that are in need of some bill assistance, that we can help them out with that.
Nice. One more thing, still doing rebates on refrigerators and things like that. Some, like, maybe if you have an old fridge in the garage and you want to get rid of it.
Yeah, we are. And, you know, a lot of people don't think about it. And you know, I don't have one now, but I used to. But having that second refrigerator in your garage, sodas or green chili or whatever you have in there, or freezer, it's convenient, but you also pay for that. So having a second refrigerator or freezer in your garage can add about $175 a year to your bill. But if you do have a working old refrigerator, one that's maybe 10 years old or older, it's kind of on its last legs, but it is still working, we can pick that up from you for free. And we'll recycle it. We recycle it down to about 95-98% of all of the materials that are in it. It's very good for the environment, but we also pay you $50 to let us do that. So we take it off of your hands. We take that energy hog of an appliance off of the power grid, making sure there's enough electricity to go around for everybody. Mm-hmm. And then you don't have to figure out how to get it away from your home if you don't have a truck or something like that. Yeah.
Well, you guys do a lot of stuff. Hey, great to see you again, Shannon, and have a wonderful summer. We'll see you again soon.
You got it. Thank you
so
much.
All right. Thanks for being here today. Yep. Shannon Jackson with PNM on our show today. It's Coffee and Conversation for Monday, the 20th of May. I'm Larry Ahrens, and we'll be right back after this.
Hey, everyone. Eric Stackelbeck.